Let's talk about your favorite quarterback, Mr. Tom Brady.
Yes.
Making some news. Rob G, where are you? Are you? Can you jump in?
I'm always here when you need me, Rob.
We don't need to bring Rob G in.
Yeah, we need Rob G. Rob G, Tom Brady got up on, made some impassioned speech. Can you give us some of the details? Because, you know, he's the Norma Ray of the NFL now. You know,
good. Like that's right.
He's got a wife who makes a gazillion dollars, and he's Norma Ray now.
The NFLPA has been fighting the good fight for a while now. They're really upset at the NFL and what they're calling, you know, overzealous offseason workout programs. And they're pointing to last season during the pandemic when everything was done virtually. They said, hey, look how great the product was on the field. We don't need to come in and do these workouts. We don't need to do on-field training. We don't do meetings in person. We can do it all from home. Well, Tom Brady jumped on their call on Friday. And apparently what he was saying is we need to have more unity amongst players, and he's expecting very intense negotiations between the NFLPA and some of these NFL representatives, including coaches of these own players. And according to the NFL Network, one thing that Tom Brady said, he said, quote, the NFL offseason is overcompetitive, and there's no effing pro baseball player throwing 95 miles an hour in mid-December. So implying, you know, the offseason is for the offseason. We don't need to be killing ourselves in person.
Now, this is where Tom Brady, this is like typical Tom Brady. First of all, the union should have been fighting for health care and better and guaranteed contracts. You know, that's where they should really put their fight in. But now here's Tom Brady to come save the day.
Yep.
Because he's been selling out his brethren for his whole career, taking less money than market value because, of course, his wife makes a gazillion dollars, so he doesn't care about that. But other guys have owners come to them and say, well, you know, Tom Brady took less. You know, we don't know how to run our books and to run the salary cap, so we need you to bail us out. So you should do that for us because Tom Brady did it for us, and you know what it got Tom Brady.
Yeah.
So first of all, he's always been a guy who sold out the brethren by doing that. Number two, now he wants this with no offseason because he's an old geezer and he doesn't want to come. And that's why this works for him and why he doesn't want to take part in it. Because all he wants to do is show up for game days now, have a cup of coffee, a sweet roll, and a chest x-ray, and he wants to play quarterback for Tampa Bay. This kills me. Really?
Yeah.
Tom, where were you when they needed somebody to stand up and fight, really fight against what the NFL was doing to the players with guaranteed contracts and all this other stuff? Really, they're going to fight for this? This is what they should unify for so that they can protect a 45-year-old quarterback who's trying to play till he's 60?
Yeah, listen, I hear you. Did you know Tom Brady was born in 1977? Can you believe that? Like that's how old Tom Brady is. 2 years later, do you know what else was born? The movie Norma Ray, which you referenced
right?
a moment ago. What the hell are you talking about? Norma Ray? That's what we're pulling up in hour three? You pull a Sally Field movie from 1979 as the comp for Tom Brady because he jumped on a conference call to try and help the NFLPA? Norma Ray?
Is it about helping the NFLPA or helping Tom Brady? Really?
Of course.
Is it about him or Tom Brady? It's always about Tom Brady.
Look, you know how many players, and this was the problem that took place at the last CBA. And this is why guys like Aaron Rodgers and some of these other guys were pissed. Do you know how many players probably didn't even vote or didn't even check the email or the details or the fine print on what would be included in the CBA? And all of a sudden the vote came and went and everybody went, wait, what did we agree to? It's not Tom Brady shouldn't have to do this. Like, guys should know what's going on. They should know how to handle this stuff. Tom Brady shouldn't have to come in because the NFLPA is a disaster. D'Amore Smith has butchered this thing for years and years now. Remember all the talk? We were having conversations with people a couple years ago. You remember when the NFLPA was coming out, D'Amore Smith and these guys were saying, hey, we're telling you right now, next CBA, we're not going to play so nice. And what did they do, Rob Parker? They agree to everything. The owners got it all, including an extra game during the regular season.
They totally buckled under.
It's terrible. And the fact that anybody's got to come in this late in the game to try and speak up and represent the players because they've – like the Juwan James thing in Denver, the fact that the NFLPA comes out and tries to bite back at the league and say, oh, you know, that's embarrassing. You know, that they would come out and expose our guy. Because here's what happened. They didn't make it clear to players when they were pushing for him, don't go to the team facilities. Don't go to the team facilities. Juwan James got hurt and might be out like $9 or $10 million because it was away from the team facility. Why were they pushing this narrative without giving everybody the facts? Like, they can't get on the same page. I'm not going to fault Tom Brady for getting on a call with these guys because, of course, he's going to look out for what's best for Tom Brady. That's why he went to Tampa Bay, because he was looking out for what's best for Tom Brady. I think the bigger issue, and we've talked about this before, people can bag on baseball all they want, man. There's not a league alive that wouldn't kill to have the strength that the MLB Players Association has. And the fact that this stuff has got to be done by Tom Brady, whoever, just goes to show you how flawed the NFLPA is. It's a
no
joke,
doubt.
Man.
They
it's
laugh.
Terrible.
The MLB players, they laugh at the other leagues.
Oh
they
God.
Laugh.
Like,
because they cannot get over, like, the NFL, all it does is brag about the money it makes.
Exactly.
That's all they do is brag about the money they make, but they don't do what's right for the players. They give them phony contracts. They can cut them whenever they want. Jonas, all these other things. Okay, look, you got to take a pay cut, right? If you underperform on your contract.
Yep.
But if you overperform, you have no recourse,
yeah,
right?
You get franchised.
It doesn't even make sense. Who would agree to such a system that's so one-sided?
And that's why when I hear, because you know how this goes. Everybody today thinks they're going to get somebody on as a guest or they're going to be invited to somebody's Super Bowl party, so they don't want to be critical of these players. But every time a player comes out and he complains about the franchise tag in the NFL – I'm sorry, man. How many more times do you have to go through this before you go, we got to take a stand? Like we got to put our foot down and take a stand. This is how strong the Major League Baseball Players Association is. Just think about this. The Houston Astros were caught cheating and won a World Series. And not only did they not lose their World Series rings or their World Series trophy.
Which was never going to happen.
Yeah, or their trophy. Rob, they didn't even get punished as long as they talked. That's it. As long as they had a conversation, and they didn't even have to come out and admit everything all the way through, because their players' association has their backs through and through. Like, no matter what. Hey, listen, people may not like this, but we got your back. We don't care what other people think. We got your back. And those guys have always had the better union and are always the envy of these other leagues like the NFL. You think something like this would happen in Major League Baseball? You think Mike Trout would have to get on a call to try and encourage guys to rally around and try and make the most of a deal they just signed for the next 10 years? They're locked into this for 10 years.
And the other one, you know, the Tom Brady taking a pay cut and Patrick Mahomes agreeing, like the best quarterback in the league and everything going on, he got $63 million guaranteed up front. Can you, what kind of, really? That's what Patrick Mahomes got? How in the world could anybody else demand anything? And do you remember when A-Rod was going to go to Boston and wanted to take a pay cut to go from Texas? And what did the union say? What?
Absolutely
You're not,
not
taking a pay cut. It's not happening.
Absolutely
we don't care
not.
Where you want to go.
And when people were sort of critical of the Fernando Tatis contract, when they looked at the deal and they said, oh, man, like we get it that, you know, look, it's money and it's generational wealth and we get all that. But, man, why don't you just wait a little bit and maybe you'll end up earning more. Fernando Tatis is going to get every single penny of that. Every penny. This is
He's
one of
22
these.
Years.